Well, as I like to say, it's a great day in Lorain, Ohio. And I remember going to the Palace Theater and seeing Melissa as Gypsy Rose Lee in a production of Gypsy many years ago. And I remember Jaclyn as Wendy when they were flying at the Palace Theater doing Peter Pan. Well, these two ladies have traveled not only throughout the United States, but throughout the globe performing. And I know that they're going to do a special performance tonight that you're all going to enjoy. So again, I'd like to introduce Melissa Driscol and Jaclyn Bradley, the Twin Flames, back to Lorain, Ohio.
Making my way downtown, walking fast, faces pass and I'm homebound. Staring blankly ahead, just making a way through the crowd. I need you, I miss you, and now I wonder if I could fall into the sky. Do you think time would pass me by? 'Cause you know I'd walk 1,000 miles if I could just see you tonight. It's always times like these when I think of you and wonder if you ever think of me. 'Cause everything's so wrong and I don't belong living in this precious memory. I need you, I miss you, and now I wonder if I could fall into the sky. Do you think time would pass me by? 'Cause you know I'd walk 1,000 miles if I could just see you. And it's here tonight. And I don't wanna let this go. I drown in your memory. I don't wanna let you go. I don't. Making my way downtown, walking fast, faces pass and I'm homebound. Staring blankly ahead, just making a way through the crowd. I still need you, and I still miss you, and now I wonder if I could fall into the sky. Do you think time would pass us by? 'Cause you know I'd walk 1,000 miles if I could just see you. Oh, if I could fall into the sky, do you think time would pass us by? 'Cause you know I'd walk 1,000 miles if I could just see you. If I could just hold you tonight.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you for being here on this very warm evening, but I do appreciate you all being here. Before, without any further show going on, I want to let you know there are beverages over there, and if you do wish to go get one, feel free to get up anytime. Don't feel like you have to wait till we're done, because we have some time. We have a show. So please feel free. So, ladies and gentlemen, you might remember me by being the daughter of Ted Driscol. Just had that, you know, music store down the street, was started by my grandfather in the 1930s, and also his brother, Paul Driscol. Thank you to the Driscolls for coming out tonight. But you also may know me from my mother, who was a beautiful dancer, singer, activist, and just a really great friend and teacher to everyone. So this is to my mother. But, you know, I gotta say, you might know me, or you may have voted for me for the 1992 Admiral King Homecoming Queen. I mean, you just might have, I don't know, maybe. I think Jill Merle coached me through that whole situation. But anyway, tonight, this next performer knew me as music director. In 1992, she played Wendy in Peter Pan, and I was her music director. Hey, Jaclyn, what was that song you sang for your audition? Jaclyn Bradley, everybody.
Yes, it is true that I met Melissa that summer when we did Peter Pan.
That's right.
And we have been the best of friends ever since, maybe because we have so much in common.
That's absolutely correct.
Yes, of course, singing and performing, but something else that we have in common is our love for adventure.
Absolutely.
I've lived in New York City, Los Angeles, Oregon, the Netherlands, Ireland, and traveled to many places in between.
That's absolutely correct. And I started my career in Germany, and I went on cruise ships as an entertainer, and I also went from Guam to Japan with the USO. And then I feel like I really just landed in New York City. It just kind of happened that way.
But nothing compares to our experiences on the stages here in Lorain, Ohio. Of course, Melissa, with your mom and dad in the business.
That is absolutely true. And of course, your parents, who are beacons of the community and just really supportive people to everyone in the arts.
Wait, why did we ever leave Ohio?
Why, oh why, oh why, oh. Why did I ever leave Ohio? Why did I wander to find what lies yonder when life was so cozy at home? Wandering while I wander, why did I fly? Why did I roam? Oh, why, oh, why, oh, did I leave Ohio? Maybe I'd better go Ohio. Maybe I'd better go home.
Now, Jaclyn, when I started traveling, I missed all kinds of things about Lorain.
Me too, I missed things too. What did you miss?
I missed, oh boy.
I missed the lighthouse.
I missed Yala's.
I missed Speak of the Devil.
I missed the Hungarian Reformed Church at the International Festival, specifically the chicken paprikash. Ildi, Jill, I'll have two, please.
I know what I missed. I missed the mayor.
The mayor. Oh, Jaclyn, why are all mine about food?
Wandering while I wander, why did we fly? Why did we roam? Oh, why, oh, did we leave Ohio? Maybe we'd better go.
Home. take a moment to thank all of you for being here. Also, Firefish Festival, what an amazing organization. I'm very happy. Yes, Firefish. I'm very proud to be a part of the artist board, so I want to thank all of the artists that made sure that this happened today, especially Candace Pettigrew. She's an amazing, amazing worker. Joan Perch. She brings all of these creative people together. Ryan Craycraft. Luke Thiel, who's running sound today, he's also recording this to make sure that other people can see it afterward. Vic Nardini, thank you so much. This space is amazing. It's going to continue to get even more amazing. We are the first real show here, so thank you for giving us that honor. I also want to give a nod to Javon Terrace, who made my skirt. We have so many artistic, creative people in Lorain, and I'm just so happy to be a part of that community. So Melissa is too. Thank you for having us. Thank you for having us sing today together in Ohio. So I started my singing career as a classical vocalist, but a couple years ago, I had the opportunity to be a part of The Voice in Holland. And it's there that I fell in love all over again with popular music. This is When We Were Young by Adele.
Everybody loves the things you do, from the way you talk to the way you move. Everybody here is watching you, 'cause you feel like home, your dream come true. And if by chance you're here alone, can I have a moment before I go? 'Cause I've been by myself all night long, hoping you're someone I used to know. You look like a movie, you sound like a song. My God, this reminds me of when we were young. Let me photograph you. Nobody told me that you'd be here. And I swear you moved overseas. That's what you said when you left me. You still look like a movie. You still sound like a song. My God, this reminds me. Like a song, my God, this reminds me of when we were young. Let me photograph you in this light in case it is the last time that we might be exactly like we were. Instead of getting old, it made us restless. Oh, I'm so mad I'm getting old. It makes me reckless. It was just like a movie. It was just like a song when we were young.
Thank you.
I was sitting on a sand dune in Santa Cruz, or Monterey, well, anyway. I could feel the trickle on my cheek of ocean spray. A perfect day. Well, anyway, I remembered that I turned to Sam and said, or was it Fred? Well, anyway, wonder why I knew the secret then. It's so simple, Sam. It's so simple, Fred. It was simple here. Where are my colored lights, beads and bleachers and colored lights? Smiles round and round, thumping boom papa organ sound. Noisy boys, long and lean, giggles of girls in the mezzanine, filtered through colored lights, gold and amber. Sailing out of Long Beach on a catamaran or fishing scow. Well, anyhow, I could feel the trickle on my cheek of cashews on my cheek. Sunset, wow. I remember that I turned to Sam and said, or was it Fred? Well, anyhow, I should be up, but yet I'm down instead. Something's missing, Sam. No. Something's missing, Fred. Something's missing here. Where are my colored lights, beads and bleachers and colored lights? Passing smiles around and noisy boys, long and lean, giggles of girls in the mezzanine, filtered through colored lights, gold and amber and green. And I tried to find the answers in the friends I made. Share anywhere with other people's music ringing in my ear. I couldn't sing, well, anything. I remember when I took a
I just could be 12 again. Or was it 10? Well, anyway, it seems to me I knew the secret then. Something's missing 12. Something's missing 10. Something's missing here. Passing smiles round and round, thumping oompa-pa organ sound. Noisy boys long and lean, giggles of girls in the mezzanine. Filtered through colored lights, red and orange and gold and amber and pink and yellow and green. Leaving home years ago, what was I looking for? I don't know. I can't recall. Well, anyway, soon I'll have my days and nights of wonderful, glimmering, beautiful, shimmering.
Melissa, that was beautiful. I see John Handyside back there. Give him a round. He ran the palace the whole time that Melissa and I were there. It's so good to see a familiar face. I remember Melissa as Gypsy Rose Lee too. I was probably 11 or 12, and to see a young woman in her own skin, so confident, really inspired me greatly. And so I'm really grateful to Melissa for being a role model to me at such a young age. You know, in our journey through life, we are met with joys and triumphs, but also changes and challenges. And if we can find someone to share that journey with, a friend, a love, role models, then it opens up a whole realm of possibilities. And just make sure Luke's okay. He told me to pause. We're good? Okay.
I peer through windows, watch life go by, dream of tomorrow, but stayed inside. The past is holding me, keeping life at bay. I wandered lost in yesterday, wanting to fly, but scared to try. But if someone like you found someone like me, then suddenly nothing would ever be the same. My heart would take wing and I'd feel so alive if someone like you found me. So many secrets I long to share. All I have needed is someone there to help me see a world I've never seen before. Your love would open every door to set me free so I can soar. 'Cause someone found someone like me. Then suddenly, nothing would ever be the same. There'd be a new way to live and a new life to love. If someone like you found me, oh, if someone like you found someone like me, then suddenly nothing would ever be the same. My heart would take wing and I'd feel so alive. If someone like you loved me,
thank you. Some of the greatest people that I've had the blessing of having with me on my journey are fellow artists. From Indiana University, where I studied voice, to the television shows in LA and across the ocean. But those allies have not just been abroad. They've been right here in Lorain, Ohio. And I want to call up one of those allies right now. Everett Query. He is a carpenter and a tenor. Here's Everett.
Thank you. Good to see y'all.
You ready, Everett? So at this time, I would like to introduce you to our music director today. He is my very best friend in New York City, and he is also our music director today. Please, John Bronston. A little bit about his career. He was the MD of the National Tour of Hair. He was the music director on the film Jesper in Deadland, and he also was the music director of the drama desk film Don't Stay Safe. John Bronston. So, one of the best things about living in New York City is meeting so many talented singer-songwriters. There's so many out there, and what is an even better blessing is when he or she or they or them can share their music. So today, we are going to do a song by a very good friend of ours.
And she is just an amazing person. And she shared this with me to share with you today. And her name is Maria Gentile, and the song is Friend of Mine. You walk in out of the blue, and from the rain just for a while. You bring stories of your travels, so much time, so many miles have passed between us, so much water under bridges that we've built. And I cannot believe we're talking as if nothing ever did somehow break down between us. Good friends, that's what we are. Well, friend, do you remember who it was who broke my heart? It was you who took all of the hope in my eyes. It was you who broke the promises I kept time after time. It was you who stole moments and left only lies. Well, that doesn't sound like any friend of mine. So after all this time, you say that we should talk some more. You call yourself my friend, but you still manage to ignore that you always put me somewhere behind you on the shelf. So I stopped waiting for you, and I learned to love myself. And I cannot pretend like you that our dreams did not fall apart. Well, I certainly remember who it was who broke my heart. It was you who took all of the hope in my eyes. It was you who broke the promises I kept time after time. It was you who stole moments and left only lies. Well, that doesn't sound like any friend of mine. I believed every word you said. And to think at one time, I believed every word you said. It was you who took all of the hope in my eyes. It was you who broke the promises I kept time after time. It was you who stole moments and left only lies. Well, that doesn't sound like any friend of mine. It doesn't sound like anyone I would stand behind. It doesn't sound like any friend. Thank you, Johnny. So, that brings us to our next song. Okay, so, this is some story. So, let me take a second. A short time before my mother passed, I had come home to visit with her, but I didn't know she was gonna pass. So that's the good news, because we had so much fun. We stayed up till 4 in the morning drinking wine, and as Marcy says, $3 wine. That is true. My father used to go pick up her wine and bring it, and Walmart probably thought we were, you know, really loving that $3 wine. Didn't know it was just for my mom, who happened to be in a wheelchair. So nonetheless, thank you, Daddy, for doing that. But we had such a great time. And shortly, I was about to get married. So she picked articles for me, and we picked out decorations. And then in tandem, we were also planning a show called Songs My Mother Taught Me. So when we were looking at songs, she recommended this next song. And we just went over all the meanings. I mean, we had tons of meanings you can put behind a song. And the meaning is yours. It's your interpretation of the song. So we had so much fun. And then as perils and coincidences happen, My spouse and I got married in City Hall, and then we had a party later. And the day we got married, my mother passed. So luckily, my beautiful sister, and thank you, Karen, for supporting as well, and my father were there to take care of her in her last moments. But it was a surprise. Like, they didn't know she was gonna pass. She got pneumonia in the hospital, and that happens. So anyway, that day, this is one of our favorite songs, and we actually sat at the piano. We scooted her off the wheelchair, and she got to play the piano, and it was so beautiful. Now, also, David Driscol, this is one of his favorite songs, one of my cousins. The Driscolls love jazz as well. It's part of my upbringing. So, Luke, are we ready? We're good, all right. This is Guess Who I Saw Today. Bye. You're so late coming home from the office. Did you miss your train? Were you caught in that rain? No, don't bother to explain. Can I fix you a quick martini? As a matter of fact, I'll have one with you. For to tell you the truth, I've had quite a day too. Guess who I saw today? My dear, I looked around to shop around for something new. I thought I'd stop to grab a bite when I was through. I looked around for someplace near, and it occurred to me where I'd parked the car. I found a most attractive French cafe and bar. It really wasn't very far. The waiter showed me to a dark, secluded corner, and as my eyes became accustomed to the gloom, I saw two people at the bar who were so much in love that even I could spot it clear across the room. Guess who I saw today, my dear? I've never been so shocked before. I headed blindly for the door. They didn't see me passing through. Guess who I saw today? I saw you. Thank you.
So when I was about 12 or 13, I asked my mom and dad to get me a guitar and guitar lessons. And it was Christmas morning, and I was sure I was going to get my guitar. But lo and behold, there was nothing that looked like a guitar under the tree. And I opened up all the presents, and no guitar. So it was okay. I got a lot of good CDs. And I took them back to my bedroom that afternoon to listen to the CDs. And lo and behold, there was a guitar under the covers of my bed. And so I did study classical music, but when I moved to New York City in the aftermath of 9/11, I picked up my guitar and I started to write. And I was greatly inspired by the music of great songwriters, Joni Mitchell, Bob Dylan, storytellers like Bruce Springsteen. And so we're going to do a Bruce Springsteen song. This is Gavin Coe, everyone. He's going to help me out today, and he is a guitar teacher at Rocktown Music Academy right next door.
Desire. Tell me now, baby, is it good to you? Did he do the things that I do all right? I can take you higher. Ooh, ooh, I'm on fire. Sometimes it's like someone took a knife, baby, edgy and dull, and put a 6-inch valley through the middle of my skull. Sometimes awake with the sheets soaking wet and a sound of a freight train running through my head, and you cool my desire. Ooh, I'm on fire. Ooh, I'm on fire.
Thank you. Hey, Jaclyn.
Hey.
Do you remember that phone call?
I do. You were singing at the Hollywood Bowl, and I was moving from New York City to Los Angeles.
That's right. That's right. And I just happened to have an apartment, a wonderful roommate,
Jamie,
and a parking space.
Yes, yes. I came to visit and decided to stay, and the rest is history.
That is correct. That is correct. Yes. And we are...
forever friends.
Forever friends.
Thanks to music.
To all of my forever friends. I've heard it said that people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes the sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better because I knew you? I have been changed for good. It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime. So let me say before we part, so much of me is made from what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. And now, whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a sea dropped by a sky bird in a distant wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for. But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes the sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? I do believe I have. Bradley.
Whew. Melissa Driscol.
She's amazing. Well, this is time for me to get really humble. My mom's house, you know, when I was like 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 40, was always the place that we'd always get together. So my friends, it was kind of in between Amherst and Admiral King and then like adjacent from like Southview. So like for some reason I was friends with everybody. And I don't know, I mean we could ask like Heather and Marcy and Jenny and Ildi, you know, what it was like at my house. Or we could wait till we go to the bar later. I mean, either way. we just talk about it. We just talk about it now. But anyway, my house was the house that everyone came to and it was really fun and very safe. Anyway, it was the hairspray. I had the best hairspray. Whenever I see someone less fortunate than I, and let's face it, who isn't less fortunate than I? My tender heart tends to start to bleed. And when someone needs a makeover, I simply have to take over. I know. Exactly what they need. And even in your case, though it's the toughest case I've yet to face, don't worry, I'm determined to succeed. Follow my lead, and yes, indeed, you will be popular. You're gonna be popular. I'll teach you the proper poise when you talk to boys, little ways to flirt and flounce. I'll show you what shoes to wear, how to fix that hair, everything that really counts to be popular. I know about popular. Right cohorts, you'll be good at sports. Know the slang you've got to know. So let's start, cause you've got an awfully long way to go. Don't be offended by my frank analysis. Think of it as personality dialysis. Now that I've chosen to become a pal assister and advisor, there's nobody wiser, not when it comes to popular. I'll help you be popular, and with an assist from me to be who you'll be. Set a dreary who you were, or nothing that can stop you from becoming popular. What is it, Jaclyn? Lar? We're gonna make you popular. When I see depressing creatures with unprepossessing features, I remind them on their own behalf to think of celebrated heads of state or especially great communicators. Did they have brains or knowledge? Don't make me laugh. They were popular, please. It's all about popular. It's not about aptitude, it's the way you're viewed. Very shrewd to be very, very popular, like me. Now this question is for Marcella. Does Scarlett know that you would come over and use my Paul Mitchell? So in the 80s, our hair was big. And I don't remember who had the biggest hair. I think we said like Lisa Schnowski won. But I was definitely in the running. And though you protest your disinterest, I know clandestinely you're gonna grin and bear it, your newfound popularity. You'll be popular, just not quite as popular.
Check. There you go. So when I came back to Lorain, I wanted to pay it forward. Melissa, people like Melissa inspired me, and I wanted to hopefully inspire the next generation of singers. So I opened Rocktown Music Academy, and I have two of those students here today. First, I'm gonna call up Roma. Roma is my daughter. She is 7 years old, and she is brilliant and kind and lovely and brave. Everything that I've ever dreamed of being, she is 100-fold, and I'm so proud of her. Of everyone I've ever sang with, she is my favorite, and I'm so glad she's here today. And also Gracie Strozek. Gracie's been my... Gracie's been a student of mine for a couple years now, and she is just such a well-rounded young lady. She models, she sings, she plays softball, she's a gymnast. She is really something, and I think you're going to be hearing both of these young ladies' names in the years to come, and one day I'll say, my gosh, I got to sing with them. So I'm very proud of them. This is a song called The Greatest by Sia, and it just talks about how important it is to shine brightly and be the greatest you can at all costs. So this is Sia.
Free to
fun. Thank you all for coming.
Yeah, thank you so much. And you know what you see here, we're going to do in New York City in February. But you saw it first here in Lorain, Ohio.
It's good, isn't it grand? Isn't it great? Isn't it swell? Isn't it fun? Isn't it nowadays? There's men everywhere, jazz everywhere, booze everywhere, life everywhere, joy. That's good, isn't it grand? Isn't it great? Isn't it swell? Isn't it fun? Isn't it? But nothing stays. In 50 years or so, it's gonna change, you know.
People that have made this show possible. I am so excited about the Firefish Festival that started right here today. Thank you so very much to all of you for coming here and being here with us. Thank you to the crew. If you are an artist who are a part of our board, raise your hand or just shout out because you're here. Come on, I see some of you. If you volunteered, you're here. Nobody's making noise but me. I just like to talk a lot. That's why I put these things on. Not really. I just really want to thank absolutely everybody for being here. We've got some snacks. We've got a cash bar. We've got three more weekends of things. We have a big fish burning again on September 18th. North of the bridge this time, we're bringing back Sammy DeLeon for an after party there, and we've got a little bit of everything. And I have two ladies to look forward to booking in the future as the opening act for Firefish. So thank you all. Have a great night. Thank you for being here in all this heat.